A very good
Clear.
afternoon to the chairperson, jury members, and to all the listeners in this session. I am Dr. Soumya Jain, postgraduate student final year from Department of Periodontology, Manav Rachna Dental College, and I'll be talking on the topic Perioscope in DNA Forensics. These are the contents of the presentation. Coming to the introduction, periodontitis is a chronic inflammatory disease of the periodontium, and its advanced form is characterized by loss of periodontal ligament and destruction of surrounding alveolar bone. Although dysbiosis of the local microbial community initiates local inflammation, overactivation of the host immune response directly activates the osteoclastic activity and alveolar bone loss. Next slide, ma'am. Cytokines are the key modulators of both homeostasis and inflammatory processes that act in the first wave of responses against pathogens and stimuli at barrier sites and connect tissue cells with lymphocytes and accessory cell populations. So this is the representation of a diagram in which how periodontitis happens is being explained. Now we know that in healthy state, the local challenge and mild host immune response are balanced. Whereas in this state, there is an appropriate number of infiltrating neutrophils in gingival sulcus, as well as the resident immune cells are present in the gingival tissue, which includes helper T17 cells and the lymphoid cells. So when the immune pathogenicity of the local microbiota is elevated by colonization of the keystone pathogens, as we can see, there is colonization of the keystone pathogens in the dysbiosis of microbia community, it overactivates the host immune response. So the immune pathogenicity of the local microbiota is elevated by the colonization of keystone pathogens, and it further leads to the cytokine secretion, which mainly participates in the amplification of pro-inflammatory cytokine cascade and the lymphocyte production. So basically, there is a destruction of tissue and it leads to periodontitis, which is inflammation of periodontium, which includes four structures, gingiva, cementum, periodontal ligament, and the alveolar bone. Next slide, ma'am. Coming to the deoxyribonucleic acid analysis, identification of humans by DNA isolation from several biological samples is one of the most sought after approach. The prospective sources for procuring DNA from the vicinity are the crime scenes. Though whole blood is considered as a prolific cache for DNA, its collection and storage requires high level precision, aseptic environment, and a professional approach. Next slide, ma'am. So this is the diagram which is basically showing the DNA fingerprinting. In this, these are the short tandem repeats, which are the basically microsatellites, which are the allele repeats at specific loci in DNA between two or more samples. And these are 2 to 7 base pairs in length repeats. Next slide, ma'am. Coming to the saliva in forensics, use of saliva and mouth swabs as sources of DNA shows some technical advantages over the use of blood, which includes the following. First, collection will be easier. Second, painless method in collection. Third, it can be done on children and elderly subjects. Fourth, does not have any religious implications which are present while using blood. And it is a safe method as compared to the blood, which has higher potential risks of contamination. Now, these are the bite marks. Bite marks are also very useful in DNA forensics, as we can see in the case of sexual assault, murder, or any child abuse. Now, there are some programs which are commonly used in victim identification, such as OdentoSearch, then Automatic Dental Identification System, which is a computer-aided software for post-mortem identification of deceased individuals, which are based on dental characteristics, especially radiographs. Third is the computerized assisted post-mortem identification system, which is used to facilitate the rapid identification of human remains by chart screenings. Then is the dental profiling, which includes extracting a triad of information. First, descendants, ethnic origin, then the gender, and then age. And last is the age determination. Coming to the review of literature, a search was conducted and various databases were used, such as PubMed, Scopus, and Embase, and many articles were seen and evaluated. Many of the search articles were the review articles, in which some were case control studies and some were RCTs. These number of articles were searched, in which around these articles showed the studies that they are related to the role of periodontics in DNA forensics. Next slide, ma'am. After studying many articles, it was seen that though blood is a prolific cache for DNA, storage and collection of it requires high-level precision, as a result of which non-invasive methods such as saliva has come into limelight since many years. Periodontics, which is the branch of dentistry that deals with health and disease of periodontium, in that role of DNA is that it is responsible for all the cell activities, yield the valuable information in both the healthy and diseased individuals, and periodontology can help in forensics in unfolding mysteries related to any criminal investigation. So how basically perio is related to DNA forensics? As we all know, the cell death occurs by apoptosis, necrosis, or autolysis. So the liberation of tissue fluids, which causes the cell autolysis, runs to cause evident decomposition of corpse. Although cementum, which is a connective tissue and a part of periodontium, surrounds the tooth and it is deposited throughout the life. So this deposition occurs in the form of concentric incremental lines, and each line corresponds to 1 year of life. And these incremental lines can be calculated as X by Y, where X is total width of cementum from dentinocemental junction to the cementum surface, upon Y, which is the width of cementum between two adjacent incremental lines. Coming to the conclusion, further research in the field of periodontics can add a new horizon to the scope of forensics, and multiple discoveries pertaining to the field of forensics can be seen. Thus, there is seen that there is a scope of field of periodontics in DNA forensics. Next slide, ma'am. These are my references. Thank you.